You want to watch Chef Boyardee, the man behind the can?
Oh, I like that.
I mean, we could watch
the
this.
The man behind the freaking can.
I feel like it's going to be a long-ass video about Chef Boyardee. Okay, let's see this. Hold on. Yeah. Give me your camera. Tell this. All right, let's watch this.
This video is sponsored by Surfshark Alert. They provide a service that helps keep you safe on the internet by
Okay, I understand.
For a
is
limited
there like
time,
a...
if you go to surfshark.deals/companymanalert,
a cardboard cutter of Lanso? We have to make that. That probably costs money, yo.
And if you use the code companymanalert,
Lanso can be a Jedi Phantom in post editing. If we get him,
Jedi Phantom.
If we get a Phantom Lanso in one of the cameras, it'd be fire.
I'm not embarrassed to admit, but I used to eat a lot of Chef Boyardee. If I remember right, around the year 2000,
Chef Boyardee was
they started selling a larger, more extreme
I always
version
had
of
this in my house, by the way.
Egg beefaroni, jumbo
Chef Boyardee?
There's like always Chef Boyardee in my house, and I'm pretty sure I ate a raw.
9-year-old me was so
Yeah, I never
biased.
Ate this shit.
I couldn't go
you
back
never
to
Chef Boyardee,
either.
Bro.
I actually recall being
never.
In the store, looking at a can
what
of the regular
my mom never bought
canned
shit.
And wondering who
How? That was just like the easiest way to like feed your kids without having to do the work.
They even promoted with all these commercials
she did
featuring
it. She
professional
did it.
Wrestlers,
she did all the work.
I can confidently say
I mean,
that these
goated.
Were my peak.
She just made the ravioli.
And then I do recall
he's opening the can
wrong,
by the way.
Aggressively worse.
Feed the need.
I must have thought that they were
spaghetti
wrestlers.
But now that I look back on
shit.
It,
bro, I literally never seen mini this. What the frick?
More than anything else, and I must
opener?
Have grown out of it. In all honesty, I can say that was.
Wait, you're being rude
and I brought up their commercials. I want to mention
something
that sticks in my head. I don't know if you remember this, but this girl tries to put a can of it in the car. To
yes, the best commercial alive.
Chef every night this week, so they leave without it. But the can falls off of the shelf and rolls out of the store, down the street, and all the way to their house.
Is there?
It stops at a red light. I don't know. It just makes me happy to talk about it. Maybe that's for you.
Even
the
stops at a red light. It's like
a
look,
good
even
Samaritan can.
Yeah, even the cans fall on the rules.
Enough respect. Not the brand necessarily. I'm talking about the person.
Yeah.
The guy that you see on the label was Boyardee. An actual chef, Hector Boyardee.
Hector?
The spelling is different, but trust me, it's him. He's the one who started the
I thought it was
based on his recipes, and he actually ran it for almost 20 years.
Oh,
I
yeah.
would say that this is one of
Hector,
the most impressive and commendable
English translation.
Stories out there.
Interesting.
Yet, in many people's minds, he's seen as nothing more than a mascot for a children's food
like him.
Product.
Nah, it's got, with Betty you know, Carter, like a mustache.
Generic old man, 57.
True. It's basically just like the KFC guy without the freaking goatee.
But, you know, I'm standing by this one.
No, it's the Quaker Oats.
Oh, yeah, it's the Quaker Oats, dude.
And maybe when I'm done, you'll feel the same way. We all associate the brand with what I would describe
do you like
as
ravioli?
Low-quality cans of pre-made pasta. I'll admit, it's not the best.
Do I love cans of ravioli?
Especially
considering I'm telling you, I used to eat this all the time.
Highly
regarded yeah, I do like ravioli.
I kind of fuck with ravioli, yeah.
Ridiculously young age, too.
I think, like, if you get, if you can order a nice ravioli, like a four cheese stuffed with mushrooms and a nice freaking Alfredo creamy sauce... Oh man, that's just fire.
Yeah, like fresh. That shit good.
Yeah.
New York, where he quickly found a job in the kitchen of the
oh,
famous
look at that.
Plaza Hotel.
A tissue box.
Now, I have trouble believing this part, but apparently, after working there for only a year when he was 17 years old, he became their new head chef. I suppose he did have
Dude,
6 years of 17? Culinary experience under his belt, but a 17-year-old running the kitchen of the plaza. I don't know, but it does seem to be the popular story that has
that's
been confirmed
sick.
By the company themselves.
He's like, he doesn't even believe it, but like 17? That's just like the difference
President
between Italian and
Wilson
American cuisine.
Getting married. It was a second marriage.
Like you just come over here, like, holy shit, you're amazing. And he's like, bro, that's
he's
like
a
Italy,
chef.
Dog.
This is just a ravioli with beef in it. Luigi?
Must have done a good job, too, because it was the
he's a genius. He put meat with the spaghetti? My God.
What?
18th birthday, Chef Boyardee, as an
Chef Boyardee.
Was the head chef at a prestigious New York hotel while catering events for the president on the side.
19, he's doing this.
Famous mustache that he has on the logo? It's believed that he first grew it around this time as an attempt to make him look older.
As a
17-year-old. When he was 27 years old, he chose to follow his dream
now he's
by
27.
Moving from New York to Cleveland, where he opened his own restaurant.
Oh, let's go!
It's called this, which translates to the Garden of Italy. I have to point out how
the Garden of Italy. That's actually a fire name.
Opening
but isn't that now Olive Garden? He's probably so disappointed.
In Cleveland at this time.
It's just Olive Garden
Italian
now.
Food nowhere near as popular as it is
this
today.
This guy's sick.
He made him have shit because he was Italian.
And let's face
I'm
it,
saying.
He was making tasty food.
So, look. He came from freaking Italy and just blew all these American chefs out of the water.
So much yeah. so that the customers were like always spaghetti? Asking him for his recipes.
Whoa, is that ass rolls? To try to replicate his
dishes. Wait, what?
Market, and ass rolls.
Was a success.
So my much favorite. So that the
customers were Yo, ass rolls! Yeah. That was the one.
The Chef Boyardee's secret ingredient.
Had the idea of taking it a step further. You would not only sell the
beef
recipe,
ass
but
rolls.
The ingredients to go along with it. Sort of oh, a very good. Early version of a Blue
Especially
Apron
Especially Chef
Boyardee's
ass
package
rolls.
Together some sauce,
That's Italian authenticity.
Chef Boyardee's nuts. Got him.
And when he started doing this, it was really just...
This guy was selling the ingredients separate. This guy thought of freaking, like, the tomato sauce would come those delivery food services product. Before it was cool.
Yeah. Did you see that? He also sold almond milk.
He milked almonds, bro.
It's just a running gag at this point.
Started to surpass the sales of the restaurant, and he started to see where the real opportunity was. That year, he moved his operations to a legitimate factory so he can increase production. And along with his brothers, Mario and Paul, started
his brother was Mario.
Yeah, and his brother was Paul.
He had Mario and Paul.
Yeah. Obviously adopted. If it's not Luigi.
But noticing an issue with brand awareness. Simply put, Americans were having trouble pronouncing it. And
yo, that's literally what we were saying.
Bro, they makes could. So much sense. But how do you? How can you not pronounce that?
How would you pronounce Boyardi? How? It's gotta be Boyardee, right? It's Boyardee.
Boyardee. That's how people were saying it probably.
The small oh business of
Boyardee.
Boyardee.
Four syllables.
To solve the issue, he made what I would consider to be a sacrifice by removing the correct spelling from the brand and replacing it with a more Americanized spelling.
Yeah, he's like, how do you sound this out?
Space out the syllables, so there was no mistake.
Chef Boyardee
I mean,
pizza.
He literally was like, "Dog, this is how you pronounce it."
Everyone is proud of his.
Yeah, it's like dictionary spelling.
Sacrifices were necessary pronunciation. For progress. As it turns out,
Italians made the food most loved by Americans just fucking carved cheese into pasta sauce. Type of business because it was only true.
Before the start of the Great the Depression, pinched fingers.
As you can imagine, an affordable, convenient meal like this was very much appreciated.
We're having beefaroni.
After 10 years, I love that beefaroni. I think I had beefaroni a lot, but like the ravioli was heat. I think like the ravioli more. It was better cold. That's why.
Milton, Pennsylvania, to be the perfect place to grow tomatoes for his sauce. The weather and the soil was good, and plus it was located right along the river.
This guy moved to a place to get the perfect tomatoes. That's dedication to the.
That's Italian.
By the 1940s, things were going very well.
This was Italian thing I've ever
actually helped by the Great Depression. They had a recognizable name. He was using what were like.
Look, even in the freaking article, he spaces out Boyardee. Hold on.
All caps, dashes in between the syllables.
Hold up.
Bro, this man's a genius.
What am I doing? Why does it seem off?
Oh, is it moving? That mustache? I don't know, man. It doesn't look real.
He's a fake mustache?
Something tells me he drew that shit on right there.
No, man, that's well, that looks a little rough, honestly. I can see what you're saying.
So as a result, they
it was a bad print.
Yeah.
240p. Size. Everything changed for them in 1942. See, World War II was getting pretty messy, and the U.S. government commissioned
to say the least.
The army. These canned pasta dishes were perfect for that purpose. So now
meatballs and brown gravy.
Damn, he fed the freaking army.
Attempt to keep up. Oh, I don't know about this one.
Production running non-stop.
This one looks a little slimy.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Slimy gravy.
At their peak, they were putting out 250,000 cans.
Wait, that's
per
cool.
Day. Once the war was
he
over,
made military rations.
He was
yeah, that's freaking
MREs.
To the war effort,
MRE.
The Gold Star, he made MREs. Which seems to be one of the highest honors that a civilian can receive. It's amazing, but there was an issue here. As I said, for the last few years, Chef Boyardee had experienced almost unlimited demand for his products because the government was buying them for the soldiers.
Right, they're just showing feet. I'm
now
so confused.
That the war was over, their biggest customer was gone, and the Pizza. Company was thrown back into the free market and forced
wow.
to compete.
Why is the whole family looking into the oven?
Yeah, it's like dangerous. No radiation issue.
Had to slow down production. They had 5,000 employees, and downsizing meant that a good portion of them
damn.
Would be laid off. Chef Boyardee.
Wait, is that their interpretation
idea.
Of Chef Boyardee right now? when he's like, young bro, Chef Boyardee. I gotta fire like 4,000 people because the war is over. Jesus Christ.
Where do we close?
What if Italians pinch their fingers because they're pulling a string for a light bulb, but only Italians can see? And part of the curse so they can't talk about it?
In 1946, he sold the company to American Home Foods in exchange for $6 million. By selling the company that he had built to a larger company with more resources, all of those 5,000 people were able to keep their
jobs.
So in reality,
he did it for the homies.
Not been the owner or in control of the brand, name on it since 1946, but he did remain involved with the company all the way until 1978.
He served as an advisor
and appeared in their commercials. He was actually making these commercials until he was 80 years old. After that, he lived another 7 years until he died in 1985.
Wait, so you think, like, we've only eaten non-Chef Boyardee Chef Boyardee, you know what I mean? That's crazy.
Yeah.
Because he sold the company before, like, my freaking parents were born.
In the beginning of this video, I argued that this man does not get enough respect, and I'm hoping at this point
mushrooms
starting to agree.
This guy's actually goated.
Just to drive
that's just illegal.
Let me go back.
This guy's like, this is the secret.
Growing psychedelics.
The psychedelics in the spaghetti sauce.
It just works. It's different.
It lets the soldiers fight better.
He should be respected. For one, and it sounds funny considering what the brand has become, but I'd say that he qualifies
Danny DeVito
as a culinary master. Of course, I can't personally vouch for his cooking skills. He was alive before.
This guy's calling him a culinary master. I mean, true. 17-year-old head chef? 19-year-old cooking for the president? Had to grow a mustache just to look older so people would respect him?
Yeah, mustache at 17?
Mustache.
It's easy to overlook, but what about the fact
what kind of genetics? This man was never going to go bald.
A desirable job.
He did follow his dream. This guy was a hero, man.
And then moving away from that to focus on a new business where he saw even greater potential.
They
in
should
addition,
release
he relocated his plant to improve
Chef
his product
Boyardee
and help
shrooms.
Give jobs to small
Chef
town
Boyardee
farmers.
Shrooms.
The gold star, of course, would be the obvious one. Even the government recognized his contribution in
that is crazy.
As part of the war.
So Chef Boyardee won the war?
Yeah.
If you think about it, it fueled
Without
the soldiers to win.
Yeah.
Bro, this guy's a fucking hero.
Act that ultimately ended up hurting him because he later chose to sell the company so his employees can keep their jobs.
Yeah, you made pretty penny
and
off that.
And the one that personally impacts me the most, without him, there would be no overstuff.
Did Chef Boyardee feed, like, everybody in the war?
Like, the enemies,
like,
do you think?
Yeah, he fed everybody. He's like, everyone gather around the dinner table. Both sides join. In a gymnasium, started eating Chef Boyardee, started having a good time.
It's just like a big bell. It's like, oh, it's lunchtime, guys. Put the weapons down. They just meet up in the middle, have a nice fucking feast of Chef Boyardee, beefaroni, and ravioli.
Italian music playing in the back.
But
yo, if that's not what happened, who was the German Chef Boyardee?
We gotta search that up. Who was feeding the soldiers in Germany? Did they have a Chef Boyardee? Maybe that's why they lost, because they didn't have a man like Boyardee.
Bro, exactly. All they had was Einstein, and then he left.
Overstuffed ravioli. I know, that's an alternative timeline that I don't want any part of. Now, I'm sure
overstuffed.
They have more reasons out of this, but I feel like it's a pretty
They probably
solid
wouldn't have overstuffed.
Especially
like,
for a
much,
person
right?
that many
No, it's not
the
good
the poor
son. Wait, that's like very French.
Finish up with the brand.
It did good put down.
American Home Foods held on to it until the year 2000 when they sold it
mini meatballs.
Conagra. It was a large deal where Conagra bought that entire segment that had been renamed
Is
International
that a weed
Home
plant?
Foods. They received Chef
I thought
Boyardee,
that was like the three stars in Pokemon.
Bumblebee Tuna, Pam Cooking
Bumblebee Tuna!
Wait, Pam?
$1.6 billion
They own all this?
Assumption of their debt.
No shot.
That's where they've been ever since. Just looking through some of their more recent reports, there's been a few impairment charges related to the brand, meaning they're writing down the value of it because it's becoming less valuable. They've totaled to almost $200 million since 2014, which
Jesus.
Is not a great sign, but I also
Damn.
Wouldn't be expecting them to go away anytime soon. Let me know in the comments, do you remember that rolling can commercial?
Hell freaking yeah.
I swear, they used to play that thing
I want
a
half Chef Boyardee right now.
More importantly, do you think...
Yo, we should do a Chef Boyardee tier list.
Hold the phone!
All the cans of Chef Boyardee food.
Okay, keep that in your brain. We're going to put it in the dock.
Yeah, I'm going immediately to the
dock. Put it in the dock. How do we find this? I think Bitebug linked it. So knowing all this, Italians can't hate on canned Chef Boyardee because it's actually authentic Italian cuisine. True! Even though he sold the company, but like, originally. So anything that's overstuffed or like double this, he wouldn't fuck with. But the original shit, he's all in, bro. Bro, take off his hat and cut both ends of his mustache. That was a German shit. Okay, no? No. All right, let's continue with this. Let's finish this freaking video.
I just don't like it. So many people think of him in the same way as Tony the Tiger, because I hope we can all agree at this point, he's much more than just the face on the can.
Yeah.
So any thoughts you have about Chef Boyardee, or
it's more
Boyardee,
of the face on the toilet,
man or the brand, or the overstuffed ravioli, or any
he's a real human that did big things. I'd like he to hear fueled the war.
Today's sponsor is Surfshark Alert.
Yeah, no, he's great.
Like it or not, well, I'm sure you don't.
I think this is all just ad, right?
Company man.
Surfshark.
Mike Company 17, the company man. Today's sorry, I just keep clicking. Yo, it was a good video, bro.
That was actually good.
I am gonna go buy Chef Boyardee shit and just eat the suck out of it because I'm just so I'm craving it now. I want Chef Boyardee.